Good day. I pray everyone is wonderfully blessed. I extend a warm and sincere welcome to all who are tuning in. Isn't it a beautiful privilege to be able to pray together as a school family? I truly thank God that in our school, we can openly pause to seek His guidance and forgiveness. Now that I have mentioned the word forgiveness, I must state that the theme of this presentation is forgive each other. We often hear the word forgive and perhaps take it for granted. To forgive means to pardon someone for the wrong he or she may have done to you. Christ offers free pardon to us, and He requires us to extend pardon to others. In Matthew chapter 6, we are pointing to the importance of forgiveness. Verses in this chapter make it clear that to receive God's forgiveness or pardon, we first need to forgive others. Verses 14 and 15 of Matthew 6 states, "For if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if ye forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses." Christ is willing to forgive us, but we first need to be willing to forgive others. It is my prayer that as Grace 5 shares the message of forgiveness, hearts will be blessed, and that we will improve our practice of forgiving others.
Now let's bow our heads for prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, dear Lord and Savior. Help us to forgive everyone. Help us to believe in you. Help us to forgive those who trespass against us. Help those who hurt us. Help us to forgive them. Let us have a good life with you in heaven. Help us to stay in your arms, in Jesus' name.
The scripture reading is taken from Colossians 3 verse 13. Do not be angry with each other, but forgive each other. If someone does wrong to you, then forgive them. Forgive each other because the Lord forgave you. This is the word of God.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for blessing us and we thank you for guiding us. We're asking for you to forgive us for our sins. May you help us to do the principles that you taught your disciples. May you guide us, and we only know that you will forgive us if we forgive others. So may you help us to forgive. In Jesus' name, amen.
Junie was getting ready for bed when his papa's heavy footsteps were thumping up the stairs. Immediately, his body began to shake with fear as he quickly crawled under the bed. All of a sudden, he felt a pair of strong hands pull him out from under the bed. "Help! Help!" Junie yelled loudly as he tried to free himself from his papa's hand. "Don't hurt me, please, don't hurt me." Before Junie could escape, Papa beat him. "Don't think you can escape from me. You're just like your mama. Bad woman, bad woman," shouted Papa as he was about to flop over, too drunk even to care. "You bad boy, bad boy." The next day, after Papa's alcohol wore off, he felt bad about beating Junie. He was calm, but Junie was too terrified even to get near him. For 2 years after Mama left, Junie's father had been drinking himself to death. He thought he could cover up the pain of losing his wife, but the alcohol didn't help. Instead, he beat Junie night after night. Poor boy. Lolo, Lola, please let me come and stay with you, begged Junie. I can't take it anymore. He will kill me soon. You poor boy. We must take you out of your father's hand, said Lolo and Lola adamantly. Junie was grateful, spending the rest of his teen years with Lolo and Lola. No more beatings, no more fear, no more injuries and bruises. Years passed, and Junie graduated from college. One day, his grandparents approached him with a strange request. Junie, we didn't tell you earlier. Your papa has been in jail and is very ill. Won't you go and visit him? Asked Lolo and Lola earnestly. What? You want me to visit him? No way! He's not my father and I don't have a father like him, said Junie angrily. No matter what he has done, he's still your papa. He started drinking only after your mama left, Lolo explained kindly. Do forgive him. We will be praying for you that God will help you to forgive, Lola said reassuringly, her Bible in hand. Finally, after months of struggling with himself, the day came for Junie to visit his father in jail. When they met, both father and son hugged each other, sobbing and crying. I'm so sorry, son, for all the hurt I've caused you, cried Papa. I forgive you, Papa. I forgive you, wailed Junie, with tears streaming down his face. It was indeed a joyful reunion. Forgiveness comes only through Jesus Christ.
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, as we come to you today, we want you to help those who abuse people, because those who are being abused do not like to be abused. And as you said, thou shalt not harm each other. And I want you to make those who are being abused forgive the people who are abusing them, and make the people who are abusing people to help them to understand that abusing people is not right. And I thank you, and I glorify your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let's pray. Lord and Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us here today to pray about those who are being abused in their own household. Lord, we ask to protect those who are being abused, and we ask to make those to realize that they are doing something wrong. Lord, we ask for the strength to forgive those, and we ask for the strength to obey your commands. Lord, thank you for all you have done for us. In all just name we pray, amen.
Do not be angry with each other, but forgive each other. Do not be angry with each other, but
Let us pray. Dear kind and heavenly Father, as we come to you today, Lord, we ask that you may forgive us, forgive each and every person out there that might envy toward us, that we have any kind of enemies. Lord, as we come to you today, we ask that if we might show each and every one of us that we have Christ, and we may show that we have forgiveness and accept your word. In Jesus' name we pray.
I love thee, I know thou art mine. Please lead me and guide me, O Savior divine. Take hold of mine idols and even my foes. Please lead and direct me in the way I must go. Oh, Jesus, I long for great peace and sweet rest. I long for the joy just to lean on thy rest.
Change your whole heart.
blood is sufficient for others, so it's sufficient for you.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for who you are, and we worship you because of who you are. We give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. Thank you for the abundant love that you have for all of your children. And today we come against all lies that is against your children, Father. Today we lift up those that are being abused. They are living in unsafe homes and environments. Father, we present them before you because some of them are hurting beyond measure. But dear God, we are thankful that you as the Heavenly Father can comfort. Help each child who is being abused to know that they are loved and valued in your sight. Father, we come against all harm that is projected on your children. We pray, Heavenly Father, for the abusers, that they will come to know you, whom to know is life eternal, that they will know that there are other healthier ways to present their cases, their stresses before you, and you, Heavenly Father, will give them the help, the solution they need to deal with it. Protect these children, dear God. Protect them, Father, from the mothers, the aunts, the uncles, the brothers, the neighbors, the family members, and other friends, dear God, who are carrying out acts of abuse against your children. We cover them under your blood, dear God, and we ask you to loose your angels all around and protect them, dear God. We forbid the spirit of unworthiness that some of them may feel. We forbid the enemy, Father, from telling them lies in their ears. Father, we lift up before you each child and ask you to break these family curses of abuse in past generations and going forward. We pray for salvation and deliverance of your children. We thank you, dear God, for releasing your Holy Spirit of love, of calm, of patience, of forgiveness into these homes. Bring these parents and caregivers to their knees, Father. Help them to repent. Help them to remove these harmful situations from their home, these harmful habits that they're inflicting on their child by your will. Father, expose all areas of darkness, all evils that are in the home that is coming against your little ones. We thank you for healing. We thank you for hearing. We thank you for protecting their bodies and minds. And we give you the glory for what you're about to do. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.